rise for the graduating class of 2019.
请全体起立，北大国际学校大学预科2019届毕业生入场。
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome one and all to the 8th annual commencement ceremony at Qingdao and Malaysia International School. June 4th, 2019 will be etched forever in the history books as the day on which we honored the achievements of our largest graduating class to date and sent them off into the wide world to share their bounteous gifts with others and to continue to make our planet a more peaceful place by their presence. In the past 7 years, a total of 11 QAIS graduates have walked across the stage to receive their high school diplomas. Today, we are pleased and proud to add 7 more names to that list for a new total of 18. Graduates, we are so thrilled to be here to share this special day with you, to honor your contributions to the QAIS community, and to celebrate reaching this important milestone in your lives. We have watched you grow up, develop your intellectual capacities and talents, and become inquiring, courageous global citizens with open hearts and flexible minds. You have mastered the rigors of the IB Diploma Programme while becoming true scholars and leaders. You are poised and ready to embark upon the next great leg of your life's journey. In your small class of 7, within the next couple of months, you will scatter across the globe and land on 3 different continents in at least 5 different countries. Who knows where life will take you next? However, no matter where you are on planet Earth, you will all share common history and common roots as only the 2nd QAIS class to complete the IBDP. QAIS class of 2019. Out of the more than 7 billion people alive today, only the 7 of you will ever be able to say that. And that is something truly special and something to be proud of. Commencement ceremonies are always good times to share reflections on life, wisdom we have gained, and advice for the graduates. Every adult in your life will probably have a different opinion and a different message for you this week, so I hope you receive and process those messages in a way that is meaningful for you, as this life is yours to create and your journey yours to navigate. So, in thinking about the message I wanted to leave this graduating class, I will keep it very simple. Every morning when I go up to my office from the elevator on the first floor, I look to the left at a small 4-inch by 4-inch quote posted to the bulletin board and read these wise words of the Buddha. Be where you are, otherwise you will miss your life. The quote has led to numerous days of contemplating the degree to which I've been able to put those simple but profound words into practice. Graduates, I urge you to think about it now. how many times in the past 13 years of school have you sat in class physically, but mentally you were somewhere else, far, far away, just staring at the clock, wishing it would speed up so you could move on? I urge you to think also about the times you've had a conversation with someone, but the words were somehow going in one ear and out the other because you were so preoccupied with some other more pressing thoughts inside your head. Again, I go back to the Buddha's quote, be where you are, otherwise you will miss your life. To take the theme further, the second part of the quote can just as easily say, be who you are, otherwise you will miss your life. For as life pulls and tugs at you and societal expectations try to influence your path, it takes a deep trust in yourself and a profound sense of courage to withstand external expectations and create the life you wish to live, the one that resonates most with your values, your passions, your interests, and your soul. So if I can leave you with anything at all of value today, I would urge you to consider these statements together. Be where you are and be who you are. Otherwise, you will miss your life. In recent weeks, similar messages have been sent to me in different forms, in different words, and from different angles from various unexpected sources. For those of you in the audience who are fans of the HBO series Game of Thrones, you'll recall that Bran has commonly reminded several characters who are experiencing confusion, guilt, or regret of a similar message in the last couple of episodes. In his words, you are exactly where you are supposed to be. While even Sansa, another Game of Thrones hero, and reflecting on all the struggles and difficulties she has endured in her life, commonly notes, if all those things did not happen to me, I would not be who I am. And then, in an impromptu email exchange a few weeks ago, Mrs. Daniels, our Brain 3 teacher, reminded me of my favorite book, Siddhartha, which prompted me to open to my favorite page to read this message. The world is not imperfect or slowly evolving along a long path to perfection. No, it is perfect at every moment. Everything is necessary. Everything needs only my agreement, my assent, my loving understanding. Then all is well with me and nothing can harm me. I had to learn to love the world and no longer compare it with some kind of desired imaginary world, some imaginary vision of perfection, but to leave it as it is, to love it, and be glad to belong to it. So graduates, if I could leave you with one more thought on this very special day, I urge you to consider the perfection of your imperfect lives. Every experience you have ever had has contributed to your wisdom and enlightenment and made you who you are. Be grateful for all of it. Every person you have met, every class you have taken, every movie you have watched, every conversation you have ever had with anyone. And as Hermann Hesse writes in Siddhartha, all the voices, all the goals, all the yearnings, all the sorrows, all the pleasures, all the good and evil, all of them together is the world. All of them together is the stream of events, the music of life. When you listen attentively to this river, to this song of a thousand voices, when you do not listen to just the sorrow or laughter, when you do not bind your soul to any one particular voice and absorb it in yourself, but to hear them all, the whole, the unity, then the great song of a thousand voices consists of one word, Om, perfection. For it is when we embrace the unity of all things that we will finally reach a state of enlightenment and peace. So graduates, on behalf of the QAIS community, we congratulate you on this fine achievement. Wherever your path takes you, remember, be where you are, be who you are, and embrace the imperfect perfection of this glorious symphony called life. Enjoy your journey and best wishes in all your future endeavors. We are proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Vicari, for a very insightful and thoughtful words of welcome.
非常感谢 Chris
Vicari 博士对毕业生的谆谆教诲和很好祝福。 Springer, or Liz, as she is known, is an internationally minded and cosmopolitan international baccalaureate teacher. She is also a caring, principled, prepared, knowledgeable and thinking communicator who always aspires to be the best person she could possibly be. It's very appropriate, therefore, that she was the student choice for faculty speaker. So I invite our faculty speaker this springer to the stage to address our graduates.
Liz老师在学生的心目中，他视野开阔，知识渊博，能言善辩，运筹帷幄。听他的课总是茅塞顿开，受益匪浅。请欢迎同学们一致推选的教师代表Liz老师上台致辞。
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. If you were a tree, what kind of tree would you be? Would you be a high reaching Sitka spruce, a stout baobab, a majestic oak, a magical beech tree with paper thin bark, a fragrant magnolia, a Japanese maple or ancient olive tree? Would you provide cooling shade, medicinal bark, nourishing fruit or sweet sap? Would you be growing wildly by your own design, or be shaped to fit your surroundings, or maybe a little bit of both? When I was little, people didn't ask me what tree I was. They kept asking this annoying question: what will you be when you grow up? As if till then, I did not count. As if my choice of a specific career was to be sole or defining mark of my transition into adulthood. As if career choice ultimately determined the kind of human being I was to be. For this speech, our graduates had asked that I look and consider how much and how well they grew at QAIS. I thought about it for a while. I considered their chosen universities and career path, and I came up with this. My dear graduates, I see you as a diverse and ecologically improbable growth of trees. I see you as a growth filled with variety of trees from near and far away countries that found their way to this Qingdao soil and learn to thrive and gain resilience in the process of getting older and sometimes wiser. Andy, you are so deeply rooted, so connected to your land, your family, and your values, that one cannot easily say where your tree finishes and universe starts. I have been deeply touched by your ability to belong, to withstand tremors and stormy winds with serenity. What tree could possibly do all that? And I see you, Cameron, as a tree whose wood resonates with sonatas yet to be played, a tree that gives away sugar without stealing it from bees, one that in her own town shocks the world with brilliance of fall colors. You have so much going on. And what about Shirley tree? I had the joy to watch your tree flicker in two-tone silvery leaves in the breeze, revealing that under the wishing to blend in facade, there is a gentle rebellion brewing in, a rebellion that may change the world. And then there is the old soul tree, a young tree, yet one already sharing fruits of wisdom. There you are. One that works hard to grow in the best possible way for those it shelters. When the tree, please don't forget to send some of the generous love to yourself as well. Now for the gentlemen. They are probably already breeding the sapiens. tall as a tree, knows what conditions benefit him, knows when to break through a rock and when to grow around. He grows where others would not dare and enjoys his edge of the cliff stage presence. Don't tell me you didn't notice him, because we all did. Noah, a tree dedicated to promotion of peace, one that remembers ancient empires, and one whose fruits would feed the flames that light up the curiosity of mankind. Of course, he may need a year or two to fully grow in all of that, though there is no doubt he's going to. And Brandon, try to tame his growth to fit your landscaping designs, and he will break the restraints. He has his own plans, his own ambition, his own timeline to get done what he needs to get done. You wish to see a towering tree, let him choose his own to exotic paths to delight. There are many things that I love about each of them, but let me tell you one more thing I cherish about them all. It seems rare today to meet people who are moved not by some tangible, measurable results, but by compulsion to follow one's own direction. There are so many boxes to fit, so many tests to take, personal statements to polish, and scores to better. There is an entire business of self-marketing for students of this generation, who are told to narrow their focus by age 12, define their dreams by age 14, write up and follow a four-year plan of improvement and complete stages of their personal life projects on time and with impeccable results. All of that just so they can stand up against the multitudes of other well-groomed and well-prepared young adults. As a teacher, I see the expectation of our students with them. The day-to-day pressure may not seem much to us, but over time, it has the power to force these wild trees into a perfectly manicured, sensible, and useful social orchards. Is that what we wish to see in the world? Orderly rows built in for high output and convenience? I don't think so. I will much rather have our untamed growth of 2019, with all their resistance, all their defiance, and wonderfully unreasonable ambitions. When I see them, I hear the words that Walter Lippmann said about Amelia Earhart, my other favorite nonconformer. Lippmann said, and I quote, "The best things of mankind appear pointless like Amelia Earhart's adventure. They are the things that are undertaken not for some definite, measurable result, but because someone is moved by curiosity, the love of excellence, a point of honor, the compulsion to invent or to make or to understand. The world is a better place to live in because it contains human beings who will give up peace and security and stake their own lives in order to do what they themselves sense worth doing ever for. What they themselves see worth doing. There are many things that I love about each one of these students. But let me tell you about the one thing I cherish about them all. Try as you may, these three won't be orchardized. They will not be manicured into uniform patterns of growth. They follow their own directions, their own honor, their own desires to understand and shape the world. The world is a better place because they themselves discovered and continue to discover things worth doing. So go-ahead class 2019, grow tall, grow strong, and shape your own path towards life.
Thank you, Elisabetta, for your thoughtful words of love, wisdom, and encouragement. A vital aspect of education at our school is our relationship with each other. The bond between students and teachers is an essential aspect of the way we learn in this school. All our graduating class are special people, and they also have some special relationships with certain teachers here.
在美亚的教育中非常重要的一个方面是师生关系，这种亲密的师生关系是促进教学相长的一个积极的力量。在我们的毕业生当中，每一位学生都是一个独特的个体，在他们的心中也有与自己关系非常特别的一位老师。I'm
going to call on teachers to introduce a graduate with whom they've had a very strong relationship, and following that, each graduate will make an address.
接下来呢，我们会一对一的请出这些特殊的拍档。首先呢，我们会由老师上台介绍学生，然后呢，学生也会上台致辞。So
to begin, please welcome to the stage Lauren Borodenko, who will introduce Brandon Daniels.
下面我们有请 Lauren Borodenko 老师来介绍毕业生 Brandon Daniels。
Good afternoon, everyone. I've had the privilege of working with musicians in the class of 2019 for several years. They are diversely talented and uniquely inspired and have been absolutely a joy to work with. I have the special opportunity to work with Brandon as we speak musically with the same voice, clarinet. When Brandon arrived, he elected higher level music, but without having played his instrument for several years. I was nervous, but Brandon quickly revealed himself to be a musician with remarkable depth, dedication, and tenacity. He also may be the only teenage student I've ever had who was an early bird and willing to have lessons at 7 a.m. Brandon pushes himself. He sets significant goals, and he is driven to achieve. I will miss hearing about his love-hate relationship with whoever the composer of the week is. Brandon, I'm confident you will ultimately settle on love for Mozart. It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage Brandon Daniels.
Thank you, Lauren, for the introduction, and thank you all for attending the graduation ceremony of class 2019. It seems as though the difficult part of my life is over. As much as I don't enjoy speeches, I would take this one in a heartbeat over the DP exams. So, due to the fact that I'm not one for many words, I'm going to keep my remarks on the other side of things. I remember a time where I didn't know what I was going to do with my future. My coping method was just to forget about it, and when the time came, I'll figure it out. The last graduation that I attended was in 8th grade. I entered high school that day with no direction other than a Call of Duty game on my laptop. Today, I'm walking out of high school with so much more than when I came in. I believe that life puts people in strange places for a reason. At least for me, that place is here. I've met some incredible teachers and students, and some of which I can now call my closest friends. With that being said, I would like to give my thanks. First, I would like to thank my parents, not for getting me into this mess that's called the IB, but for supporting me throughout these two struggling years and all the years prior. I guess I can forgive my mom for letting me play piano all those years ago, then trying to stop it after a while. To all of my teachers, thank you for the help and support during my time of need, regardless of the amount of work that I was behind on. If not for you all, it's possible I would not be in this position today. To my closest friends, there isn't much I can really say. From basketball games, to mountains, to music, to family guide quotes, to every single movie possible. I truly found a group of people that I can say are the ones who shaped the way I am and the best version of myself. To the student body of QAIS, thank you for being the glue that holds together the walls of this school. Without this diverse group of funny, intelligent, and smart people, I wouldn't be able to grow as much as I want in this environment that I enjoy so much. And finally, to my fellow graduates, I'm not sure how to describe our 2 years together. If I call it a roller coaster ride, I think it would be too cliche, so I might just call it tumultuous. We went through the ups and downs of a typical DP class. We had our troubles, we had our fun, and we survived through DP. As we go our separate ways, I want to thank you all for being the people that I was able to always have as supporting classmates for these 3 years. My high school life is nearing a close. Thank you everyone for all the support over these past 2 years.
Next, please welcome Peter Marie, who will introduce Cameron Daniels.
For those of you that aren't aware what I'm like as a teacher, I'm a self-described science clown. Way too excited about science and the natural world, and I can't wait to tell others about it. So you can imagine what it was like in my first lessons teaching Cameron, the embodiment of Grumpy Cat, if there ever was one. From day one, Cameron really made me work for a laugh or even a smile. My bio puns were accompanied by the chirps of crickets and the slow crawl of tumbleweeds. Nevertheless, I vowed to get Cameron as excited about biology as I was, which is no small feat. Over time, I got the pleasure of seeing glimpses of the passionate and energetic side of Cameron, and I wanted more of that. So I decided to troll her, so to speak. She is passionate about being vegan and the viola. I am not. So I challenged her to convince me why I too should care about these things, but she needed to convince me objectively. These kinds of exercises really allowed me to see the spirit of Cameron, and when she puts her mind to something, she is a force to be reckoned with, even if she doesn't believe so. Then something happened. Cameron liked biology. No. She started to love biology. We would often converse about global issues and the politics surrounding their solutions and what can be done. Speaking with her, you get this amazing sense of care. She genuinely wants the best for the world. Today, I am proud to say Cameron is one of the most impassioned, budding ecologists I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. There is no one doubt in my mind that she will be successful in her endeavors. The only question is in what fields will she impact? Music? Science? Both? She's already impacted my life. She's made me want to be a better teacher. Who else will she change for the better? Ladies and gentlemen, Cameron Daniels.
The relationship I've built with you is one that's instilled is pivotal in my life. Your passion for biology, your humor, empathy, kindness, and intelligence in many aspects of life inspired and comforted me in the darkest of times throughout this past year. Choosing you to introduce me was a no-brainer. I hope to remain in contact with you next year. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for attending the graduation ceremony for the QAIS class of 2019. To my teachers, thank you for consistently supporting me, especially during such a rigorous program. Through all of the deadlines and stress, you all have always been there for me and were always willing to help. The immense amount of time and energy you put in certainly deserves to be commended and is appreciated by all of us. I value the relations I built with all of you, and I hope I will hear from you again in the future. to the QAIS student body. Your laughter and positivity was such a blessing to walk into every day. I know I may not have gotten to know you all well, and some of you I barely know at all, but I truly wish for all of you to have the most success in the years to come. To my fellow graduates, thank you for supporting me not only in school, but in all aspects of my life. I feel that whether or not we were close, the relationships I built with all of you are relationships that last a lifetime. Andy, thank you for your positivity, your innocence, and your kindness. Your optimistic outlook on life is something that I admire so much about you. I hope you carry that through your life. Noah, you were the first person I met in this country, and you made the move to China so much easier. Although we've had a rough time in our friendship, I can genuinely say thank you for always showing me new perspectives and your support over 2 years. Brandon, my twin, from birth to graduation, you've witnessed everything in my life and still managed to put a smile on my face, even in my darkest times. Thank you for being my rock. Wendy, I've enjoyed learning about your culture and finding the similarities between us. Shirley, your laughter, light, relatability, and reliability are just some things I value so much from you. Thank you for being such a great friend to me, and I can't wait to take trips to see you next year in the UK. Lastly, Paul, you're probably one of the most smartest people I've ever met. Humble, kind, and helpful. Thank you for your very understated humor. I will miss it very much, and I wish you the best of luck in America. My time at QAIS was a time full of growth, learning, laughter, as well as my self-discovery. I had some dark times here in China. I was close to giving up many times. But without the support of people like Mr. Marriott, classmates like Andy and Shirley, in all honesty, I may have not been here. However, thank you to everyone at QAIS for allowing me to spend these past 2 years here. I'm excited for the next chapter of my life. And I wish you all success and happiness in your school.
Meet on camera, thank you both. Dr. Vivian Sui will now introduce Shirley Ma. Xiangyang woman, Yo Qing, Dr. Vivian Sui, Bolshe, Jiu Sha, Ma Mingzi.
It has been 5 years since I first met Shirley. From MIP to DP, great changes have taken place in her life. It is not only the accumulation of knowledge and the progress of academic learning, but also the achievement of skills and the open-mindedness in her personality. Her journey has been full of growth and self-discovery. What impressed me most was her comprehensive university trip to the United Kingdom. Shirley independently planned the entire itinerary, worked out the schedule of the university visits, took detailed records and reflections, which provided the basis for her college application. I saw a confident girl who had found her life direction ahead and stepped forward formally and bravely. It is my great honor to introduce Shirley, our outstanding graduate, to the stage and give us a speech.
Thank you for all the support and assistance that you provided for me. I wouldn't be where I am today without all the guidance, help, and additional tears you've been providing for me. As most of you noticed that I have a hard time for my first year of EP, I literally have a lot of mental breakdowns in my first years. And without the support and effort that everyone, every teacher putting on me, I don't think I would be standing here right now. And secondly, I would like to send to all my friends, thank you for the encouragement, advice, and joy you brought to me. So, first of all, I really want to thank for Gabriella. I don't know if she's not graduated this year, but yeah, she's my only classmate for my first year of DP. You're not only my friend, but also my mentor, who always gave me a great advice and helped me to make decisions. And complaining with me, which I doesn't sound like what a mentor supposed to do, but I really appreciate all the complaining that we've had together. Thank you so much for helping me to go through the darkest year that I ever had. And now it's super. So Andy, you are the kindest person that I have ever met. So thank you for your positivity, your optimism, and your simplicity. I really appreciate that. And Cameron, my wifey, my workout partner, you are a very cute and honest person. And the first white friend that I got really close to. I will keep in touch with you no matter where you are, and do remember when you came to visit me. And Wendy, I have learned a lot from you. I mean, it's really good to know the differences between a K-pop and a sushi, and three different ways of how you count your Korean age. And Brandon, you're one of the few people that I know who has a relative pitch. And I always tell, and you can always tell most of the instruments correct from any extra piece. And Paul, I really appreciate you, your funny presentations, and all the other humors. It's really fun to meet you. And Noah, I enjoyed the time that we spent together, and I'm impressed for your whistling skills. Like whistling through the whole QAIS piece. And yeah, it's my honor to meet all of you, and I'll always remember you. Finally, I want to congratulate to all the fellow DPs. Yeah, we made it. All of us survived from DP. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Vivian. Next to our stage, please welcome Joel Sanford, who will introduce Andy Ashley.
As a teacher of 20-odd years, you see students come, you see students go. Some you remember, some you'd like to forget, and some remain with you for a lifetime. Andy is one of those students. Sorry. Not because of her talent, which she has in spades, but because of her depth of thought, sensitivity, stubbornness, strength of spirit, and courage to succeed. As her teacher, I've watched Andy overcome difficulties, learn to take risks, and let go of her need for perfection. But most of all, I've watched Andy learn to smile, and for me, there's been nothing more rewarding than that. Andy, I hope you remember, whatever your future endeavors might be, that creativity is an open concept. Continue to take risks and push personal boundaries. And love and be passionate about what you do. But most of all, I want you to remember to keep smiling. No matter how hard or difficult things might be, if you're not smiling, it ain't worth doing. It is my privilege and honor to introduce Andy Ashelman, graduate 2019.
Assume feels unrealistic that we survive IBDP. We're graduating here today, right now. I've enjoyed 12 years of school life, and half of that was spent here at QAIS. Some may say that I've trained a lot since 7th grade. Well, I will agree with that. International school is so very different from my Chinese primary school. For example, I would never have imagined being able to have a class all to myself. And seriousness aside, I really love the self-directed freedom bestowed upon me here. In QAIS, I'm situated in a grade where my classmates don't stay longer than 3 years. I've got to meet new people every once in a while. It's challenging, but also eye-opening. Here, I want to thank my family, including Dilsa, of course, my cat. Thank you for giving me your unconditional love, wisdom, and encouragement. Telling me you can do it when I'm feeling desperate with my assumed important assignments, like EE, which some of you may know struggled with a lot. Writing giving speeches or maybe communicating with words in general is not my strongest suit, but you guys were always there for me no matter what, and I really appreciate that. It gives me a lot of comfort, helping me explore my identity freely, who I am now, and who I may become in the future. I love you guys. I want to thank the 11th graders. Thank you for sticking around, not changing schools doing MIP and MVP. You guys gave me a rope to grasp onto and what could have been a lonely situation. I was able to form ongoing, continuously developing friendships. I really appreciate all the time you spent talking about nonsense, joking around, doing work, being serious, talking about issues of concern. Your company makes school that much easier and happier. I wish, I know you guys will do great in DP too. Now I also want to thank my DP classmates. Can't believe how far we've come since the summer of 2017. I'll start with the Chinese squad. Shirley, you're also one of the lone class survivors. I was super happy to know that we were going to be classmates at the end of the DP. In the first day of class, I had a friendly face to look at whenever I was unsure embedded within the crowd of new people. Thank you for your considerateness, cheerful attitude, and patience, really. You and Wendy are like preservatives, letting me go of character, allowing me to not care as much, and keeping me from going out to class. Paul, my Chinese classmate of 1 year. Sorry for leaving, but it's okay. Shirley and Vesuvian are great company, I'm sure of that. It was really nice to have you two Chinese speakers. I was able to have Chinese conversation in this all English class. Thank you guys so much. Wendy, our only Korean, from Sami Da. You made my days full of laughter. We could be singing Frozen songs, trying to remember Harry Potter spells, or simply burst out laughing till tears run down our cheeks during bio class, with no reasons, or reasons unknown. I hope you all best in your journey onwards. Okay. Now, my fellow Americans, the true Californian, Noah, thank you for being the camera person, the fact checker, the ongoing, the go-to history search engine, especially for technology-related content. And the super duper English norm. And now the twins, who may or may not have twin telepathy. I admire your chillness and I'm thankful for your understanding and complicated situations. Cameron, thank you for sharing so much with me. Your vegan baking is amazingly delicious. And your cats are at the level of pumpkin and cupcakes. I've learned a lot from you through the good and challenging times we've had. I wish you have a great gap year with your family next year. Now I want to thank all my teachers for school and for life. You guys do so much of your effort to ensure our well-being. Thank you for the challenges you brought on, chasing me to meet deadlines. Your patience, dedication, enthusiasm, guidance, creativity, and understanding. DP was 2 years of turbulence.
I would question myself whenever I didn't have work to do for any evening, because I knew that was very unlikely. But you guys were very flexible and very supportive, and I'm very grateful for that. And this brings me to the end of the speech. Thank you to everyone that played a part in my life so far. I will carry and cherish these memories to my next destination. Thank you.
Thank you so much, John and Andy.
For your delight and entertainment, I welcome our graduate ensemble, Shirley Maher on the pianoforte, Andy Ashelman on the violin, Cameron Daniels on the viola, and Brandon Daniels on the clarinet to perform Mozart's trio K-498, second movement.
Okay.
Thank you, graduates ensemble, for that beautiful performance. I don't think a graduation can be a graduation without some folks like it.
谢谢毕业生乐团带给我们优美的合奏和精彩的表演。
So now to continue with our introductions, please welcome Brendan Madden, who will introduce Paul Pei.
让我们继续下面的拍档介绍。我们下面有请 Brendan Madden 老师来介绍毕业生 Paul 裴少宇。
Nice job, ensemble. Paul came to QAIS, a shy, quiet, introverted student, kind of nerdy, with stellar math and stellar physics skills. I'm happy to say that after spending 2 years in DP physics, I haven't made his physics or math any worse. However, he has become a confident, strong, and hilarious young man. Paul is unlike any student I've ever had in the past. He doesn't take notes. He doesn't write anything down. During class, he just sits there, stares at the board, and gives it like a questioning face, like, I don't know what I'm talking about. He's just like. Yet he seems to sop everything up like a dry sponge. And once he does this, it just really becomes a part of him, and it's with him forever. That, or he doesn't take notes because his handwriting is so bad, I don't even think he can read it. It's worse than mine, which is pretty impressive. My favorite times with Paul have been times we spent entire classes standing at the whiteboard arguing over a physics topic. This would usually result in Paul pulling out some kind of trigonometry identity that I've long forgotten, and he solves it way easier than I was trying to show him. I will miss these times in class, our times hiking mountains. We're watching you teach younger students about science. Vibrations! And of course, after lunch, hearing you and Ada argue sweetly over different physics problems. Remember, Ada's always right. Paul, as you leave QAIS and go out into the world, I'm gonna echo what Dr. Bakari said and Buddha before him, I urge you to enjoy every moment, even the moments that suck. The hard times, these are the moments that make up your life. They make you who you are, and they are very limited. Thank you for all your hard work and all you have taught me over these last 2 years. The University of Pittsburgh and the world are lucky to have you in it. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Pei.
Thank you, Mr. Madden. First, thanks to our teachers, those who taught me and those who did not. Thanks to my parents, and thanks to all the staff working at QAIS. I also want to thank all my classmates and friends here. It was you who supported me all the way to this point. It was you who was standing beside, giving me the momentum to move forward. And here I am, graduating now. So now that I'm leaving, what can I do for my fellow students who are still in the journey of QAIS? What can I give back to you? So I decided to leave you all a gift. My middle school principal gave this gift to me, and now you are going to inherit it. I'm leaving you two basins of water. One basin of hot water. One basin of cold water. Wash your face and hair with the cold water. It will give you a clear mind. Wash your feet with the hot water. It will give you the energy to move forward. With power and a clear mind, I'm sure you'll have a positive, exciting, and fun lecturing. Again, thank you all.
Thank you, Brendan, for
the to introduce Wendy Kim. Please welcome Jun Park.
I remember the beginning of our journey at QAIS. She and I became a new member of the community at the same time, and we have grown instantly. Over the last 2 years, we talked and read together, engaged in conversation on various topics, from the condition of love to world issues and many more. I must admit, I enjoyed her company very much. This student has become a mature and intellectual and responsible woman. I'm really proud of her. Here she is, Wendy Kim, Seung Kim.
Regardless of whether they are good things or bad things, I should move on and live my life. And QAIS is the life I lived. I believe that I was very lucky to meet all six of my classmates. I will cherish the memories I have for the rest of my life. I really hope everybody good luck on whatever they will be doing in the future. Thank you.
And last but not least, please welcome Dr. Dan North, who will introduce our May.
Good afternoon, Noah. I was the last May teacher. Introducing Noah, I promise my speech will be really, really brief because I know that his will not be. I'm very proud now, I'm really excited that he's going to be studying on my home continent of Europe, one of the, I guess, top five continents in the world, but also in The Hague, in the Netherlands, where I used to live. And not only that, the university you're going to is going to be within a very short walking distance of the Royal Library, where I used to work and study. So after the ceremony, I would like to give you some overdue library books and give you some Let me just tell you one thing about Noah that tells you everything that you need to know about his character. When he arrived at this school, he didn't have a musical instrument, which he needed to take GP music with his father. So he learned from scratch how to play the Rusa, did I say that right? Sure, let's go there. He learned how to play this instrument, a traditional Chinese wind instrument, which he probably never even heard of before he arrived in China. This demonstrates to you quite succinctly his courage, his persistence, his diligence, his hard work, his determination for self-improvement, and the lengths to which he will go to avoid taking my film class. Joking aside, Noah is that rare thing, an actual intellectual, one who does not weaponize his knowledge and his intellect to belittle other people, but uses it instead to help, support, and entertain the people around him. He has a heart as big as his handwriting, and I give you Noah Bain.
Dear QAIS, I stand before you today to discuss something I hold very close to my heart, the IB Learner Profile. I would like to use this time today to discuss how I've upheld these building blocks in the IB in my own life, beginning with the tenet of risk-taker. I personally admire the IB's chutzpah to take risk-taker as a learning profile, but I believe that in niche ways it can be applied to myself. I went out on a limb to hop on a plane from sunny Sonoma County to come out to Qingdao, China, to study in a program which I'd only heard horror stories of before in the US, the International Baccalaureate. I think this experience ties into another key piece of the learner profile, open-minded. By taking these risks, I've opened myself up to another challenge, and in the process, become more knowledgeable. Another profile piece, by the way. Without this unique experience, I would have never taken a music theory or Chinese course, but as an IB learner, I am an inquirer, and out of pure curiosity, I have challenged myself to undertake these courses. But now I'm here. I'm speaking to you all at my graduation. If anything, this whole speech is a reflection, or a representation of being a reflective learner. I now don't have to worry about those upcoming assignments or assessments, and I'm able to reflect on all those late nights and see what I gained from them. Over the past years, I've also been able to reflect and see areas in school which I've been able to actually succeed in. If not for Ms. Alshveda or Dr. Gan, I would have never created a paper or a piece of writing like I can today. And because of them, I've created a work of writing in each of their classes, which I am truly proud of. This may seem like a small milestone, but being able to take pride in my work has removed my fear of writing, and I genuinely look forward to the day when my homework is a research paper, not studying for an assessment. Well, in the spirit of reflection, I have so many teachers to thank for getting me to the point where I am today. While I've never identified myself as a terrible math student, I've never felt like math has really clicked for me. With the help of Mr. Ed and Mr. Daniels, I feel like there isn't anything I can't tackle. I have the terrible personality flaw that makes me want to give up as soon as I get confused because I become too embarrassed to not know something so rudimentary. But luckily, there's never been a concept that I feel I haven't been able to approach Ed or Stefan about. No matter how simple, everything else stops until I can understand it, and because of this, anything is possible as long as I have one of my guys with me. And unlike any teacher I've had before, Dr. Dan has found a way to turn dreaded vocabulary memorization into a good time. But not only vocabulary, but Dr. Dan can turn any situation into a lighthearted, conducive learning environment. It may be his corny British humor, or maybe it's just the superpower he was granted upon getting a doctorate. But while it may be corny, Dan is the person introducing me today because, well, I enjoy that corny humor. I'd like to thank Dan for always being approachable, whether it be hot takes on movies or desperate questions for my assessments. Dan, I'd like to thank you for your instrumental role in developing my skill in writing analysis. I believe that if we would have never crossed paths, I would not feel the confidence I do now going into college soon. Next up, physics. You may not have all worked with Mr. Madden in his classroom, and if you haven't, you've missed out on his ability to take two random objects in a room and create a complex physics model out of it in seconds. Additionally, Mr. Madden has created a topic of our four guys, a team of us four guys, not because we thought he was cool for letting us to play hooky and go hiking, but because we knew how dedicated Mr. Madden was to helping us succeed. He understands the importance of a connection between teacher and student and knew that an hour hiking and talking can be more valuable than an hour of review. Because of this, even though I fear physics, I never had to worry when I was confused because I knew Mr. Madden would do everything he could to explain it for me. Next, I'd like to thank Mr. Allman for your fun and your light and fun attitude as always. If anybody knows Allman, you know his love for Titanic and leopard print vests, but people may not know how his fun attitude can make anyone's bleak days brighter. At every school I've been at, music courses have always been free credits, but I was quite wrong with IB Music. And let me preface this, please don't think I was taking your course for a free credit. Luckily, I'm studying with the most qualified person for the job, Lauren Borodenko. While I've always felt miles behind my peers in music, Lauren did nothing to encourage me. And while I don't think she can quite relate to my perspective with and struggle with music because she's, well, amazing at it, every success, regardless of how minor, she's used as a platform to push me to do more. She's also used this to make me work harder, and working hard is something that Lauren knows better than anyone. She's always somehow doing 10,000 musicals a day with preschoolers to middle schoolers, and has the energy and time to closely help every member of our little music cohort. Lauren was one of the first people I truly connected with at QAIS, and I'm so grateful for being able to know her beautiful family and her kind, hardworking spirit. I feel like I have to extend some final special thanks to Ms. Liz, my history teacher, EE supervisor, and the person I've tortured with thousands of questions every day. Ms. Liz, just like Mr. Madden, has had a special lesson plan every day because this crazy, wonderful woman would wake up at ungodly hours every day to plan special lessons for us. And even when I would score poorly in her class, Ms. Liz would do nothing to encourage me. And when I thought I could score higher than I was, rather than scoring lower, Ms. Liz would always be there to instill confidence in me. Ms. Liz has fostered a love for history inside me and has taught me to feel proud when I work hard. And I hope she is proud of the hard work she puts in every day with us. While I'm fortunate to have all these amazing teachers and peers, and I'll always love the little rugrats running around at QIS, I look forward to the day when my hallways are surrounded by professors and like-minded peers, rather than squirrely toddlers. And while my mother and father, who I'm so grateful for, may be reluctant to see me go, they know how excited I am for the next step of my life in Holland. In conclusion, I'd like to bring up the final IB profile of Karen. I'm so fortunate to be surrounded by parents, close friends, and teachers, whom I care for so deeply. The people in my life I hold close to me are my driving force in life, and I'd be nowhere without them. I wish QIS and everyone here the best in life, and am eternally grateful for my time here. Thank you.
Our second musical piece today comes from Paul Bay, who will sing Young Innocence.
Hey, yo. DJ JD, let's get
Thank you. Thank you.
time for the main feature, for the Super Bowl, if you like.
现在呢,是最为激动人心的时刻到来了,我们要进行毕业证书的颁发仪式。
To present graduates with their diplomas, I want to welcome Dr. Christopher Vicari and Dr. Bradford Bernhardt to the stage, please.
我们有请科学科学博士和Bradford博士为毕业生颁发毕业证书。
Graduates, please line up.
毕业生请列队准备。
Andy Claire Ashwood. Students, we are proud to present the graduating class of 2019. Congratulations, graduates. Please present to your seats.
祝贺大家都顺利毕业。 请回到座位。
Now, I wish to introduce to you the QAIS choir to share our light with you, to light your way on your next journey as you leave our school, and to give you light to share with others that you meet. The choir will sing the song, Flashlight. venues today to celebrate the graduating class of 2019. We welcome parents, guests, and teachers and staff to join graduates outside, where you'll have the opportunity to take photographs, and then on to our reception at the cafe.